I'm a big fan of the VHS look, so much so that I made a full episode all around the nostalgia of that look on my show Film Riot, where we shot a few old school formats like VHS and VHS-C, which you can find a link to that in the notes below. But of course, you can get this great analog look in post as well, so today we're looking at a few ways to accomplish this inside of Premiere Pro. My go-to method for the VHS look is by using Maxon's VHS plugin. We just drop that on and get a great look right out of the box, but you can take that further and customize to exactly what you're looking for. You also have a variety of presets to choose from, and you can change the aspect ratio and even have a transition plugin to help sell the effect. But if you don't want to buy a third-party plugin, you can still accomplish this using what's included inside of Premiere Pro. With our clip in the timeline, we're going to create a new adjustment layer. This isn't a mandatory step, but it will make it easier to make adjustments later on since everything underneath the adjustment layer will be affected. But now we're going to open Lumetri Color, go into Creative, then raise the faded film to 50 and lower the sharpen to minus 50. Now we're going to adjust the shadow tint to introduce a bit of green, then drop in the noise effect, raise that to about 30% or whatever works for you. Next, we're going to add VR blur, which will also add a little bit of distortion. If you want to avoid that, then Gaussian blur will do just fine. The main point here is to soften our image to look more like it was shot on tape, so we'll set the amount to about 7. Next, we're going to drop in VR chromatic aberrations. This will help us separate the red, green, and blue channels. Like with the other effects, we don't want to overdo this, so play around with the controls to see what looks best on your specific footage. Now I'll add a mosaic effect. This will give your footage that downgraded look, and we're just going to adjust by eye until we're happy. If you're trying to make it very low res, you can set your horizontal and vertical blocks to something like 480. That's a bit too much for what we're going for here, so I'll set both of mine to 720. And for a bit of an extra kick, I'll check sharp colors on. Finally, we change our aspect ratio by adding a crop effect and cropping the left and right. And you can see here that we've downgraded our footage quite a bit, but there's still something that's missing, and that is the tape damage you get from shooting on VHS. To achieve this, we're gonna look for an asset on a stock footage site like Adobe Stock or any of the many free options online. Once you have your overlay, drop it on top of the adjustment layer, then change the blending mode to either screen, overlay, or soft light. The blending mode you like best will depend on whatever asset you choose, so play around with all of them to see what works best for you. But now we have this. If you want to take this a step further and really sell the effect, then you can highlight your layers inside of Premiere, right-click, and replace with After Effects Composition. Inside of After Effects, you're going to duplicate your clip layer, right-click, pre-compose, then make sure you move all attributes to the new composition. Now go to Effect, Transition, and drop on Venetian Blinds. Change the transition completion to 50%, the direction to 90 degrees, and the width to around 5. If we solo the layer, you'll see these black lines across your footage, and we're doing this to recreate the look from an old CRT TV where your VHS tape would likely be playing from. Next, move your pre-comp layer one frame back, and you now have this CRT effect. To add a final touch, we're going to create a new adjustment layer and call it Warp. Go to Effects, Distort, and drop on Wave Warp. Set the wave type to Smooth Noise, the direction to 0, then adjust the wave height and the wave width to whatever looks best to you. I'll be keeping it more subtle, so we'll do around 25 for the height and 10 for the width. Now change your wave speed to about 0.5 and set your pinning to vertical edges. Finally, just mask out the top and bottom of the warp adjustment layer and feather a bit, and you have this final VHS effect. If you want to create some damage lines, just animate your mask path going down by tapping the stopwatch next to mask path and create your keyframes. But there you have your VHS look done without any third-party plugins. There are, of course, a ton of ways to approach this type of effect, so if you have any tips from your own process, feel free to share in the comments below. And don't forget to like and subscribe, because the shortest war in history lasted just 38 minutes.